Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Now, I'm not sure, I think the last video that you would have seen would be the video on August 29th, which was, what was it? My 10x10 capsule wardrobe. So that's the last one that you would have seen. But I did make a video before about a NoSpendAugust. So I thought I'd come here and give you an update about my NoSpend. So NoSpendAugust, my rule, sorry, there's a bus passing by. My rule for my NoSpendAugust was that I would only be allowed to buy groceries and essentials. And yeah, pay the bills. And transport was not included because, you know. But how did I do in the whole month of August in terms of not spending on non-essentials or on luxury items or on things that I don't need? Okay, just to give you a background, my average spend in the last 6 months was $950 per month, peaking sometime in June with $1,275 on non-essentials, like really shopping. Okay, you would think that because we are all working from home and in isolation, not really in quarantine, okay, but in isolation, working from home, that I wouldn't have any time to go to the shops and shop, or I'll be too scared to actually be around people. But then we were blessed, or maybe cursed, with online shopping. So really in the last 6 months where I was in isolation up until July, so started March, April, May, June, July, about 5 months of self-isolation and working from home, I had spent a lot of time online looking at things to buy that I don't need. I bought a lot of clothes, I bought a lot of bags. I did sell a lot of bags as well, but I did buy a lot of bags. Let me know if you want me to do a updated bag collection, because I just got another Gucci bag that arrived, and two other bags that I'm waiting for. I know, but don't judge me, okay? Yeah, so the first 2 weeks of August, I was actually pretty good. I think the first 2 weeks of August, I spent a total of something like $72. The whole 14 days. So it's almost like $5 a day if we split it that way. Actually, up until the third week of August, I did pretty well. It was at the last week of August that I caved. And that's when I ordered that Gucci bag. And that's also how I ended up with the other two bags that I am waiting on. Oh, and there is a Bottega Veneta bag that came as well. So those four bags are the culprits to my spending. In total of $319 or $316.19. Yes. Okay. Because I got my Gucci bag and my Bottega bag from eBay. So secondhand, obviously. And it didn't really cost that much, but it still made a dent in my. I really wanted to keep it under $100 for the whole month of August, but alas, my will was not strong enough to survive temptation. And I think it has to do as well with my how much I spend on social media, how much time I spend on social media. I had muted a lot of the Instagram people that I follow that sort of like influence me or give me ideas about all the stuff that is out there that I didn't even know existed, but now I want to buy, you know. Case in point, this Gucci bag that has the horse bit, the horse bit handle. Yeah, this was influenced by Emma Hill because she bought one, I think, off of Vestiaire Collective. But she's got the bigger version with the leather. I have a canvas Gucci. She's got the leather one, and that one's much heavier, much bigger than this one. But still influenced by Emma Hill. Yes. So yeah, case in point, watching YouTubers, following them on Instagram, seeing what they're buying, kind of made me feel like I was losing out, or I was, what's it called? FOMO, fear of missing out. There you go. I was missing out. And the fact is, I've got like 20 plus bags already. In fact, what I had done was redo or update my clothing inventory. I have 260 items in my clothing inventory at the moment, including bags, shoes, and all my clothes. So yeah, it seems like it's a lot by the sound of it, but that's because I count like my suits as by the number of pieces and not by the set. I'm trying to justify myself. Anyway, yeah, so that's how my August went. So I, in total for the month of August, I spent $316.19, which is still a lot. I think it's still a lot. However, it is a good reduction from my average of $950 a month. So I actually did save myself about $600 went into my savings account from what I haven't spent in the month of August. Now in September, I know that there's a few things that I will need to spend on in September. But what I have decided to do is, instead of being very strict, well, it wasn't even very strict, instead of restricting myself to a no spend, I am doing a no spend weekday in September, which means that essentially Monday to Friday, I'm not allowed to spend anything. And look, I'm working from home, so I shouldn't even have transport costs. But there are days where I work from my friend's home, just because it really gets lonely and I get cabin fever when I'm by myself the entire week. Or sometimes I really just want to step out of the house and get some air or whatever. So transport is still going to be allowed during the week, but because we do our groceries on weekends, and because I'm not supposed to be eating out since we do groceries, so I shouldn't be spending anything else on weekdays. I make my coffee at home, I eat at home, and I really shouldn't be going anywhere because I'm working Mondays to Fridays. So I will allow myself to buy non-essentials and essentials on the weekdays. However, I will give myself a budget, and that'll be $50 for the every weekend, for a total of $200 over the period of September. I think we only have 4 weekends anyway in September. So yeah, a total of $200 for the whole month of September is my budget for my non-essentials. Okay, so if I wanted to buy a dress that I find at an op shop or a secondhand market, I would be allowed to do that only on the weekend. And well, markets are usually only on the weekends anyway. I would be allowed to do it only on the weekend, but I have to cap it at $50 that weekend. If I spend that $50 on a Saturday, then that means no spending on a Sunday. Okay. That includes, by the way, eating out. So the $50 over the weekend will include eating out, shopping, anything that's non-essential. If it's not considered as grocery or house essentials, like toiletries and stuff, then that's going to fall into that $50 per weekend budget. That's my plan. Let me know if you want to join me in this No Spend Weekdays September. Leave your name in the comment section down below. If you have Instagram and you talk about, you know, the no spend kind of thing, please leave your Instagram in the comment section down below so that I can go ahead and follow you and we can cheer each other on. Okay. If you haven't already, like this video, subscribe if you haven't, and hit that notification bell so that you know when I publish videos. It's usually Friday evening here in Australia or Saturday morning in other parts of the world. All right. I'll see you all again in the next video. Thank you. Bye.